Congratulations! Today is your lucky day. You've won a prize worth $100. There's a slight catch. You only have two choices about how to use that money. You can either buy two tickets to the closest amusement park, or you can save it toward the purchase of a new computer. That amusement park trip sounds awesome, right? Roller coasters, flume rides, funnel cake. Oh man, I love funnel cake. And it's only going to cost me $100? Sold. Wait, $100? Is that really all it costs? There's gotta be more to it than that. Well, the true cost of buying the tickets is more than $100. The true cost includes something called opportunity cost. In today's lesson, we're going to be discussing opportunity cost. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to answer the following questions. What is opportunity cost? How do you calculate opportunity cost? How does understanding opportunity cost help your decision making? And you should start thinking about the big picture question. Why should you care about opportunity cost? You know, if life were really fair, we'd be able to go to the amusement park and save up for the computer. It really stinks having limited resources, but unlimited wants and needs. Wait, that sounds familiar. What was that term again? Oh yeah, scarcity. All of us want to make the best possible choices, and because of scarcity, this requires carefully comparing your options. One way to do that is to consider opportunity cost. That's another one of those terms that might seem familiar to you, but when economists use it, they mean something very specific. So, what is opportunity cost? It's the value of the next best alternative that must be given up when making a choice. Another way to think of it is as a trade-off, or what you give up or sacrifice in order to gain something else. Let's circle back to our original example, your contest prize money. So, you went ahead and bought those amusement park tickets, but what did you give up in order to do that? Well, you could have saved that cash for a new computer instead. Saving was your next best choice, and the value of that choice, that's your opportunity cost. Now, you might be wondering how to calculate that value, right? Don't worry, we'll dive into that in the next section. Time to answer your first guiding question. What is opportunity cost? Okay, so you know opportunity cost is the value of the next best choice. But how do you calculate that value? What do you consider as part of that value? Is it only about the money? Actually, you might consider the trade-offs you would have made by choosing option A instead of option B in terms of time, money, and other resources. You could organize all these trade-offs into two categories, explicit and implicit costs. Explicit costs are costs you can count, like actual out-of-pocket expenses. Examples include the money it costs to buy a product or pay for a service. Implicit costs, on the other hand, are costs that are not tangible or measurable. These costs could be the value of the time or resources that could have been used in a different way. So, in our example, what is the explicit opportunity cost of buying the amusement park tickets? Well, It would include the $100 ticket price, plus any interest that you could have earned by saving that money instead. And what would the implicit opportunity cost be? It would include any potential benefits that could have been derived from being able to purchase the computer earlier. For example, if you needed the computer for work or school, delaying the purchase could lead to lower grades, missed opportunities, or even lost income. Now, we talk about calculating the opportunity cost, but as you can see, the trade-offs can be kind of hard to quantify. How many dollars is an extra month of having your computer really worth to you? You have to weigh the explicit and the implicit costs. You have to look at the big picture to decide which alternative is best for you. We'll get into the details of how exactly to do that in the next lesson. Now it's time to answer your second guiding question. How do you calculate opportunity cost? So, now you understand what opportunity cost is and how to calculate it. But why would you want to? Is it really that useful? Think of opportunity cost like calculating the what if of life. What if you had chosen a different path? How might things have turned out? Understanding opportunity cost can help you make better decisions because it forces you to weigh your options and consider the trade-offs. But why does it matter? Recall that time and resources are limited, so we want to make the most of them. In other words, opportunity cost matters because of scarcity. Let's look at how opportunity cost impacts some other major decisions you might face. For example, choosing between college and entering the workforce. College can eat up a lot of time and money, but it might also land you a higher paying job. You'll need to think about the costs and benefits of different schools, degrees, or training programs to find the best fit for your wallet. Then, see how that stacks up against the perks of earning money right away and kickstarting your career. Opportunity cost helps you make smart choices and invest in your future wisely. Or how about a career that pays well versus a career that you love? In a perfect world, you could find a career that checks all the boxes, something you're passionate about, and pays big bucks. But let's be real. Every decision comes with some give and take. You might have to choose between two imperfect options. Opportunity cost helps you weigh those options and make the best call for your unique situation. Now, let's go big picture. Opportunity cost is important at the macroeconomic level as well. In a nutshell, countries, like people, have to make choices about how they allocate resources, whether it's investing in education, infrastructure, or healthcare, understanding opportunity cost helps policymakers decide which initiatives will provide the greatest benefits for their citizens. And that impacts all of us. All right, it's time to answer your final guiding question. How does understanding opportunity cost help your decision making? Okay, let's recap what we've learned. Opportunity cost is the value of the next best alternative that must be given up when making a choice. You can calculate the opportunity cost by looking at the value of the explicit and implicit costs of that trade-off. Remember that some of these costs are hard to put a dollar value on, so you have to look at that big picture and consider what matters most to you. So, there you have it. Every choice has trade-offs, and understanding opportunity cost can help you choose the path that leads to the most happiness and success. Keep that in mind as you navigate the wild world of adulting, and you'll be well on your way to living your best life. Next time, we'll look at how to use opportunity cost in a cost-benefit analysis to really up your decision-making game. Until then, this is Bea, reminding you to keep investing in your future, one lesson at a time. See you next time. Hey, hey.